doing the last checkups of making sure everything is working and the stream's up and running. All looks good so far. Okay, so if anyone stopped by or poked their head at my video last time, you may notice that this is not the character that I made. And I will be getting back to her. I just want to show off some of the things that I've unlocked in my personal file. Oh, because I've gotten way farther. Because I think I only have... In that one, I'm only going to have a Jarvis and these beginner sets unlocked. But I have some of these later. It's still low rank. It's not high rank yet. But these are still... as far as I know, but there's some cool stuff. But I also wanted to show, currently in this set, let me pull this one off. Yeah, I'm still using Great Jaggers. This was the set I decided to make early on, and I've stuck with it because there's little point to making multiple low rank armors. It's just more work is really all you're giving yourself. Because you have to collect all this stuff for low rank, and then you'll eventually, when high rank is unlocked, you can upgrade it to the high rank levels, but at the same time, it's usually easier, for the most part, to just remake it. And that way, no grinding, multiple grinding sessions involved, you just make them as you go. So, I think the only reason to do low rank is I know sometimes the high rank skills can be different than low rank, or maybe it's G rank, and that's not in this game. But sometimes the rank will change some of the skill sets, and sometimes you may prefer what the low rank offers to the high rank. But it's usually, this is actually one that I really want to get for my current one. Like I mentioned, I think with the origin, hair color, hair types can change, and that's usually one of my favorite type of armor sets. Because that way it's not different. Plus, these are some great skills for, I think, any weapon class. Divine Blessing, this comes from my little charm that I already have equipped. So, quick sheath. Easily put your weapon away any faster, so that way you're not getting rammed into while putting your weapon away. Affinity increases critical attacks, so more damage for each hit that's critical. Reduces stamina depletion. Makes it so the sharpening with the whetstone is faster, so if your weapon's sharp. Even if your weapon sharpness is good in general, it's going to deplete over time, so anytime. So being able to quickly sharpen it, and that way, one, if the monster's still in the area and knows where you are, or you can get through it without having it ram into you, like I mentioned with the sheathing, or if it's running away from you, quickly sharpen your weapon and then run after it. And then this one grants protection against bleeding, which is sort of, because the monster that this armor relates to does cause bleeding, and so that's probably why this one is related. It's the first one I've encountered that also involved a bleeding stat, so I'm not sure how useful that one will be, but these other ones are already very high. And plus, this one's also very good. Adds stun effect to draw attacks, and slightly increases attack power. So you're getting more stun, which stun usually works well with. I'm not sure stun will relate to the whole knockout system, where they'll get dizzy and whatnot, but it could also stun relates also to staggering. So even if they're mid-attack, stun it. And it's so they're no longer attacking you. Which is very helpful. This is the latest and greatest one that I just unlocked with this Rathalos. So, that may not This was one of the ones I was also in the beta, which actually isn't that bad of a set, just for basic. Thunder Attack and Thunder Resistance is sort of take or leave it. I sort of hate the elemental attack ups just because they're only really useful if you have a thunder weapon. The resistance is great because that way, hey, this monster uses fire or this monster uses thunder. So I don't want to get my shit kicked in every time they use it, so having this is more helpful than I think the attack, because at least personally for me, I tend to go for status type weapons, so that really doesn't help me at all, especially since I don't have any thunder weapons in either file. Health boost, windproof is very helpful for flying monsters. Defense boost, attack boost is still part of my trouble, but defense boost is always good. And then let's show off more trees. I'm more of the charge blade, so I'm more familiar at least with trees. So I think I showed off the tree in that file, but after a certain point it will also extend. And I can't really see anything, but I know I can get there. It looks like that underdevelopment part is actually where it will extend even further. So there's going to be even more, which is just awesome. Weapons, unlike armor, are perfect to upload, because even though I have all that tree unlocked, I can only do this one, and this one. I can only make four. So to get to a lot of these, you have to go make this one, go down this way, and then make another one, go down this way, make another one, go down this way. Luckily this one, I can make it itself. So, saves a little bit of the time than if I had to, go down every single one, which you still sort of have to do from Muslim. But now, since I showed all that off, just me, just my little Mayella, off of this one, I will switch over now to my inner file for these streams. And I also have made a decision for this, which is I did jump into Annan earlier today, and I did not progress the story any. I didn't do any of the events, none of the cutscene, none of the cutscene progression and whatnot. What I will be doing, I will be jumping into it though frequently, and I'm doing private sessions as I usually do, move for solo, but what I will be doing in between streaming and stuff is grinding, and so my rule for it will be I will not hunt any monster that I haven't hunted on stream yet, and I will not progress the story. This way I can do some grinding without having to worry about streaming and making sure all the setup is right, and that way I can also keep myself familiar with bow, because I'm not using a bow and I don't plan to start crafting bows in my main file. I want to keep this strictly to this. But I did also make one other decision, which is I want to have a fallback should the bow not work for me. Like, for whatever reason, the monster is not that great with having a ranged weapon for, because sometimes it's just harder to deal with a ranged weapon on some compared to others. So what I decided to do is I sell basically all the basic starter weapons that weren't, I didn't think I would use. So we're keeping, I have a bow, a bone based bow, and the iron metal bow. So this is the starter one that I already upgraded last time. I think I made this one earlier today. And then for main fallback will be the Kinsect blade. Because it's honestly one that I'm not really at all familiar with. So it works out well. Because it's similar to the bow. I've touched it before, but I haven't really gotten into it. So I played around with it a little bit today. And upgraded it a little bit to get more familiar. But should both of these fail, I'm going to fall back onto longsword. Which is another one that I probably have more familiarity with these two. But I also have not used it since 3. So these will be very fun to play around. This one's very quick and reminds me a little bit of the dual blades, but just in a different way, just because it's very fast and swing it, get a few hits in. But still, main go-to, always start with, will be bow. And that's sort of why I also want to be able to do some stuff outside of stream, just to get more familiar with it, more comfortable. And so I hunted a lot of great jaggers today, because that's the only monster that we have I haven't fought on stream yet. It shouldn't be too bad.
Okay, let's get this expedition underway. We need the game.
He's been saying that forever. I think the only thing I did do was I did talk to the provisions manager. We can see that little checkbox. And I sort of need to, just because I need to open up all these investigations. Investigations are sort of like side quests, which the only thing different than some of the other ones is you have some special conditions. Like normal time limit for a quest is 50 minutes. This one you get 30. Even though. Or you get 2 feet. Or 5. Why would I need 5 feet? Or yeah, also if you're doing these online, max players is 2 instead of 4 for some of them. So I was doing a few, running through that one a few times. Nothing up there yet. Let's see. Do we have Mago? I upgraded great drivers a lot. Oh yeah, I found Angela. So he's roaming around. I'm not a fan. So here are low rank rewards. I think I mentioned this last time, but I don't think I had it unlocked yet. Which is drop materials, head broken, you get the mane, chest broken, you get the hide, and four legs broken, claw, and what you'll get, the frequency of it. This is all very, 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 very helpful. And there's Zora, the one that we're tracking down. I'm pretty sure we're gonna learn. Oh yeah, because one of those investigations was capture. When you capture a monster, you'll find it here. And then usually, eventually, they'll add in a arena quest based on the monster that you captured. So yeah, so here are the this is what I did for capturing Angela. Well, 30-minute time limit, so that's why they have a little exclamation point. You also get ups and reward money, paint 2 times, there are upsurge in materials, depending on the quest. And those little boxes are bonus items that you'll get. So for completing this, you get an extra set of items that I think vary depending on the quest, or maybe just sort of random, just like everything else. But unfortunately, the bow I have does not allow me to really use the power. And unfortunately, no one is saying that. And also, this is the crafting materials. Yes, crafting. Do I even see it? Okay, I can get these. The problem is, I have almost no sleep paralysis watch out, so, and I'm gonna turn off all this auto-crafting because that's dangerous. It can be helpful when you start getting a lot more materials and you already know, this is what I'm using this for, this is what I'm using this for. But, these, I still have a lot to work with. Eventually there will be like a farming station open up and that will definitely help, but until then, it's gonna be a lot of me scrounging up the resources. And once this guy unlocks selling the vials, I'll have what I really need to deal with it. Okay, before I... Because I'm lazy. Oh wait, you can't go to the canteen that way? Goddamn. I was going to the workshop for that method a lot. I thought you were the canteen too. No, just a gathering hall and all my business that I don't go to. Okay. There's money. Oh yeah, I did do... I hunted a lot of great drag rest, but I also did that mushroom quest in the middle of the floor. The sad part is, I still only have those two that I originally remembered from my first eight mile found the area with a lot of them. Because I'm not fucking doing back and forth doing those two again. Especially, I'm pretty sure that's where I found Angelon since I didn't get info on him. Just because. He's there, just walking back and forth between the areas that you need to be, making it so annoying. I don't know why I went down here, because I didn't need to, but fine. Actually, I don't even need to do any of that. This is true. Oh yeah, anyway, I found a new campsite. This is, I actually found it in this file first, so I went in my normal one access there also. You can unlock multiple ones, and this one's actually more of a story-based unlock version, but there will be other ones that are, hey, you found this. Bring in the materials and we'll set up a new campsite. And those are mostly helpful depending on the quest, because this area is so massive that instead of running across the map to track down a monster, it's, hey, let me walk over to here and I'll be closer. I also had the issue where I was hunting two great jaguars. I fought the first one and then spent probably 20 minutes trying to find the second one. And I just kept running into Angela. And so instead, then as soon as I warped in the area, I ended up finding it. Which is honestly the most annoying part of it. Because I spent 10 minutes. And then I warped to another website, and all of a sudden it shows up. How nice. Oh, I also learned about these things. Okay. Yeah, there's more Angel. I think. Actually, does he have any more weapons around here? Because that's just... Ah, crappy already. No. No. Okay. If I let you fishing. You have so much patience to catch all the little coiled fish. I hate this one. This one actually is not too bad. There we go. see if I can show up. Oh, wait. Oh, there it is. Amphenol's a great warning signal. Okay. Is something to capture? And it's orange. Come on. Orange. Yeah. You gotta see. Oh, yeah. I find it all the time. And I don't know if there's anything that will lead me to wherever they're trying to lead me to. Because I've seen those markings all the time. I've never had supplies taking me to here. Here seems to be doing all these little duels. Why is there somebody over here? See, there's some investigation items, so that's another one of those little side quests that you can do. Those are limited number, though, so you can only do those investigations for so long. Though I have duplicates of, like, 5 Great Tyrannosaurus ones, bunch of Hunt the Small Monster Down, and it's insane. So basically, I'm going to go there for her to tell me how to complete those lessons. Hopefully, I can hear the songs now. Okay. She needs to shut up. That's another thing about her. Obviously, I have started to hate her. And the canteen, there's a point where they will actually just, hey, you want to cook your food for so many research points? Makes sense. Just a little bit easier. Also, where is the other exclamation point? I thought I saw it. There you are. But yeah, I've had the handlers run to me. I swear to God, she's the dumbest character. Because you see her with the Great Dragons the first time, but then she ends up doing it. I'm trying to remember all the monster research she's done that with. Because started with the Jarvis. I don't think she's really gonna get off. She does it at the start of Cobalt Heights. Oh, I'm trying to think of all the monsters that she just run out in front of. When I showed the armor up that I want to get, and that has a really, really good set, a grip line. I honestly don't know how to see the monsters in Oregon or something. Does it with that one. And she sent me about like 4 or 5 times, and I was like, you are an idiot. I don't know how. Because technically, the premise is we're A-list hunters. Both of us are A-list. Oh. She's an A-list handler of the Fifth League. And. And I'm the A-list hunter working with her. To me, it seems stupid that someone who is a handler, who should know how, hey, hunting works like this, it's dangerous, should not be going out in front ahead of the hunter, the person actually capable of taking down said things. And honestly, it annoys me so much. Because she's... It's so stupid. I think that's like this for... Okay, I think that's the one that she's looking for. So her deal is this. And how am I supposed to do that? No. Okay, I'm pretty sure that's the type of thing where if you catch these sort of monsters, you can also put them in your room.
Over here.
Coming up, I guess.
Take care of that pest.
It
won't last
the night. Oh yeah. You look too. Okay, good, right. Where are you going? There.
Return to base from an expedition.
That was the hardest area from the world.
Switch to the world map. Then select the stairs.
Thank you. Part of why I don't like the union system is because you can get screwed anyway. Why don't you have to come to the union? Oh my god, I thought that was ready to go off. Second, I was terrified. Anything that needs to be picked up or can be picked up on. One second, I'm almost. Hey. is, Great Giant versus Far Away. Okay, my... I took a look at my overlay because I wasn't sure, and doesn't really cover much. It covers a lot of this tutorial stuff up in that corner that covers, I guess, here it's have got a weapon, evades, like items, sling, dash, whatnot, basic control stuff. My Jarvis is hungry right now. I'm not interested in fighting right now. And doodles. Can you track more doodles for me? That one for me. I thought we'd be back to three. Kind of fun. Try some not. Here's a shortcut. Okay, next one. Honestly, I have not tried it before. So I'm unsubscribed. Don't loot me back around to be in front of me. Okay. Because I feel like that might happen. Okay, we totally one of them. Oh, we just went around this way. I don't know what's at the end of this, if there is anything, but I'm curious, so I'm going to keep going with it. There's another one. Oh my god, this would have made my Rathalos hunt so much easier. I could have walked here. Didn't want to know something that Rathalos. Crap. Oh man. I don't know something like that. Bug trappers. Oh my god, this is so cute. Oh, I have not seen this before. There's no friends of the bug trappers. Oh yes, my Meowster theory is the bravest fire in the whole research collection. Their name was the work? Yes. You are fleet of foot in the forest pass. I suppose you are qualified. Very well, we welcome you to the bug trappers. Thank you, oh thank you. Our warriors carry this gadget as a symbol of our tribe. Take it. When you need help, call on us. We will answer. Oh my god, that's so cool! This is awesome! Not what I want to do. Oh man, this is so cool. I know crap. Back when the, I think Gen and 4 Ultimate, or at least Generation. Actually, both. You could have multiple Winkos, and I would have one King and one Trapper. Be a good trapper that just sets down traps over and over again. And the best possible. And it's the best.
Hi!
We're done right now. Okay. We go. The core are good. I need to get the hands. I'm still just running around collecting stuff. Because it's basically. I felt like there's a territory where you can go and do anything. That's fine, please go get fun. That's ridiculous. Whatever. Can't get anything. Okay. Okay. is right in the way of... This is where we have the station. It's like so much easier. I'm honestly surprised because there is an item that lets you walk back to base. And I'm surprised it's even in the game. But I guess those can also be used in battle where regular warping you have to be out of battle to be able to get by. I'm so glad I found that though. And maybe that means I can also make games here to learn trapping for resistance instead of healing. Because my previous my normal personal file, they're dynamite healer, but I haven't unlocked anything else. So maybe this is how you unlock. Hey, here's how you get a Plinko that does mostly traps or mostly attacking. Okay, now I got the Northeast camp in here that I can also. So who wants to get more ingredients at the canteen, more ingredients at the canteen, means that canteen upgrades, and you get more cute little cookies. So bounties are things that you can do across multiple things. This line here, one mark wants it. And it's always good to have you armor spares and rewards for two. It's just, here, put these on and get stuff. And we add nine crops, nine finish mark wants it. Just added. Complete requesting nature force. Play 8 small monsters. Boom. So I've done 3 diamonds and more. I've done 2. Food deliveries. Don't have them. Oh, more speed damage. And large. Monster bone large. I think I'll get that if I have an angel. Maybe. Yeah, that. I think it only requires one. Because if it required 35, that would be a little more expensive. Okay. Nope, not you yet. You. Hello. I'm not sure how to pronounce it. Grimlickness? I'm calling grandma. Because I won't be able to pronounce anything else. Grandma are type of land that are native to the New World. Okay, so grandma are the New World's Palico. Grandma and Lingo. But these are the ones who can't eat up passion fruits. And with help, they're very similar. They offer Ka. Oh, then by my nominees, you say the word. Okay. I never unlocked this. Because I never got that thing with the butt trap and all that, so that should be fun looking into also in the personal article. Because, good lord, I love to. Because I keep seeing the doodles and I'm like, where are these? Oh. I filled up 9 meters and I'm nothing.
Good luck.
Yep. See? Perfect timing. Also, hi, I already got for my last section. I'm gonna look back to playing ahead, and that's sort of why I want to do these streams more often as I can. Because, unfortunately, I don't think I'll be doing Monster Hunter next Saturday. I think my plan will probably be to play The Last Guardian, because for two reasons. I never finished it, and Shadow of Glasses is coming out real soon. So I'm really excited to see that one come. But so next we have Speak to the Commander. So basically running around. And so send message us there if you feel like you need help, and it's been so little in this part, not really into it. Now, time for the cute. Oh, I forgot something I wanted to show on my own. Because I was showing off some of the liking or art that I was playing on. Like I said, there's no point getting armor. A lot of armor for low rank. There's your starter ones, and you may want to get one other one to make, but it's really not worth it to make multiple. Try not that one too. But it is. I'm thinking people might be what I go for. But I'm not quite sure yet. I may hold off and look at some of the other ones that I get have in my main file and see which one might be better. Just currently I'm sort of happy. I'm really happy with what Great Dragon is. And the only reason I got that one is because it has an Intimidator skill. And that's just helpful because when stupid the little Jagras start noticing you, and when you're tracking down a monster, you can't use Scout Bite anymore. So now, okay, what? I have to speak to the handler before I can actually get my quest. I hate this. Just give me the quest. This is even stupider because she says she has all the quests around the quest board, but I specifically talked to her for this one. Oh, yeah. Oh, this is in the sign. Yeah, it's in the sign. Okay, so basically any assigned is basically a quest, because I cannot do any of these ever. Because they're storming-based, cutscene-related quests. Optional. Temporary upgraded as many times as you want. Investigations, like I said, there's a limited number. I can do this one 5 more times, 4, 5, 4, 2. And events are unlimited, but this one I don't have access to yet because I'm not in a current or hunter rank 6. Yeah. HR is not a good monogram just because you have hunter rank and then you also have high rank. Whatever. And we're gonna do. Where is this one located? That one. And do it. Because I'm pretty. pretty sure where that Haven Cup symbol is in that upper right corner is where Kiki normally can go. Kiki's probably... Is it meant to be Fuki? Because honestly, I don't want... I'm normally named Kevin. So I have a monster named Fuki. Fitting, though. I'm not even trying to insult it. That's just its name. That shit, I'm literally trying to insult. So Fuki is sort of what I consider to be New World Giant Pyros. Long Tongue. Poison. The only difference is this one has feathers. And Giant Pyros has rubber skin. Or Giant Pyros, or whatever it's pronounced. It's hard to tell. And even when the game pronounces it, sometimes just sounds wrong and still, so it's like, no. I'll go with whatever little nickname. I think the only ones I know for sure are Rathalos and Rathion. But those don't actually make sense. There's a one person walking near me. Don't want Grand Dragons. Okay, he's like right over there and I'm passing. That's fine. Okay. Where is the other corporate? These are important to collect even if it's not for the one I'm hunting. It's important to know who else is here. There you are. And there's I'm has on that one, so he's pretty smooth during the area. Honestly, my more than common is like, oh, really, you should overdo this. Are you freaking ready to get me in the bone? No, but I have to do that. We'll try to eat, or will eat, anchor jackets. Separately, bear up and whatever freaking fish is called, we'll have to force and literally go out. Thank you. Are you sure, Scout Buzz? Because when you float away, you don't want me on it. I didn't tell me who it is, but I'm pretty sure I know who it is, but you're not telling me. Was he just like, okay, who's in my space? Oh, it's this dumb fuck. Don't believe, and then... Oh god, I should have been crossing over the river, and I, unfortunately, don't have those stupid mantles yet to hide. Okay, good. Oh. Rathalos is rightfully something to be terrified of. And I'd probably be terrified of Eon right now too. Rathalos is the favorite of monster of my friend who got me into Monster Hunter. And Eon is their partner favorite, who's actually not their friend, so. It's actually kind of cool. I have really, really good luck with that. I mean, this is before he was already limping and ready to die, and I'm just like, how much did that short altercation with Eon fuck you up? Because I didn't expect to have such little issue with him. But it was like, I barely hit him, maybe at all. I definitely didn't get any charge shots at all. And then all of a sudden, nope, I'm done. I'm looking away. I'm like, okay. So apparently, Eon is super effective. I'm gonna grab that monster when I get to it. I have not marked it here yet. But it's also known as the Flying Squirrel, if you've seen anyone else talk about the series. Because that's basically what it looks like and what it basically is. Okay. For an hour and a half, almost, roughly. Okay. That's why we collectible less than that, but I want to get through, I've done two more monsters. Let's see if I can get one more monster done. Duke is actually someone, like, I think I mentioned that. I may get Duke's set. But I'm not sure about it. I do need to get a better set, though. I can't stick with leather forever. Origin might be slightly better in comparison. I'm not sure. I didn't look at the stats of it. It might be, but
you've done well.
It is just called Pukey Pukey.
Listen up.
I hate this mission. This mission sucks.
The Elder Dragon investigation. Make sure you know what you need to do.
One, because I'm both Ravion, who I am baby. Two, it's the introduction of Barrow, and another point of it. No, I don't think the hammer is different from this one. That's here's another one. Let's see. Let me go workshop. I don't know what I want over there. So they won't let me do it. They're not nice. I really want to do it and then coming back from the expedition and saying, I'm going to go straight through the workshop. It's a cute set, which also is a big component of what I pick on with this, is how does it look? I don't know what this is. Both of it looks cute or cool. This one, I'm not a huge fan of. I know it's the one I'm using. But look-wise, I'm not a huge fan of it. But that entire leader set is just like a couple. This one looks a little weird than this one. I've seen best work before, but before it was not like armor completely. I like bone, but total defense. Okay, this at least gets me up to 30. This one's 40. 40. Yuki gets me up to 60 basic defense for that one. So maybe I will go ahead. And oh crap. Oh, the flying squirrel has thunder in its next one. It's the thunder. Jarvis is bad against fire, and I did okay against Rosie. And it also gets in that. I'm not too worried about flying squirrel with thunder. So, I think I will go ahead and work on getting this one. And the reason I wanted this one was item prolonger is a good some duration, some item effects, so Poison Abyss and Poison Attack is always open. Poison Attack, especially because, like I said, I'm used to using Fast Elements, so I usually know. Pull it in some sort of poison. Plus, since I'm using Bow, once I get the Poison Vials going, I can mark off the poison. There's some monsters out of my head, so that's always helpful. The Spore Puff Vials that you can use to hide will also heal me. And then Botanist. I'm not a fan of doing that Wildfire thing quite yet, so you know what? That will be first thing next time. And this way, since I'm pretty sure I'll get the PK set, and I may get multiple sets for this one, just so I can, one, mind that I need more practice with the bow, so gathering materials is sort of secondary to that, so. I'm going to be hunting the same monsters over and over again, and I'll have enough material for it. So, I have to worry about doing stuff like that as much. Plus, I'm not doing the main game. So, and I may just look over in my personal file and see, okay, I want X armor, Scrubus armor. The weapons I'm using, but and I may also mess around with the staff next playthrough, next stream rather, so that way, because like I said, I want Bow to be the main one, but I also want to use that one as my secondary for close range, and I definitely need to use it and get familiar with it as well, so I'll probably be switching between both between now and next stream, and then switch between both a couple times during stream going forward. Let's see. They taught Gigi how to talk to Jagras, so there's some room, so I'll try. Okay, yeah. The bow trapper instant canes used to stop monsters in their tracks. It's a vigilance or race type. This varies with the type of insect and size. Durations increases his proficiency. Interesting. Okay, yeah, I'm definitely not happy. I'm so happy that I found that. That is great to have. And now that I know how to find it, it's so much better. Anyway. This is going to be it for today's stream. I'm glad these people can do it more than once a week. I think I'll be trying to pepper them in a little bit more throughout the week, but my main day is always going to be Saturday. Saturday is the absolute. I will squeeze it in at some point during Saturday. It was usually my goal when I'm doing that. And if there is any issue of, hey, I'm going out of town, I won't be able to, then it will always be advance notice. And hopefully I can also squeeze an extra stream before then. Just speaking.